farm workers in solidly blue states are apparently being denied various labor rights, including in the state of Maine. So let's talk about what farm workers have just experienced under the leadership of their Democratic governor, who just vetoed a bill that would actually give them more labor protections. Luke Savage wrote about this in Jacobin and gives us the context necessary to understand just how horrific the governor's decision was here. He starts off by noting that the National Labor Relations Act of 1935 and the Fair Labor Standards Act of 1938 both played a significant role in establishing basic labor protections and empowering ordinary workers, the former notably enshrining the right to join and participate in a union. But guess what? Unfortunately, not all workers were included in those labor protections. Carve outs for both domestic and farm workers aided the continued exploitation of two sectors that have remained particularly vulnerable to this day. So in Maine specifically, you have a lot of agricultural activity happening. For instance, they produce eggs, potatoes, blueberries. In fact, I believe Maine is the only state that produces wild blueberries and also maple syrup. So they're incredibly important. Those farm workers are incredibly important to the agricultural industry. And so it turns out that there was a pretty aggressive fight to ensure that these labor protections, which apply to most workers, were extended in the state to also apply to the farm workers. In fact, one state representative, his name is Thom Harnett, said this: agricultural workers have been specifically excluded from basic labor laws that protect most workers. Currently in 2021, Maine farm workers are still not considered employees under state law. By way of example, they are not covered by Maine's laws regarding minimum wage and overtime. What is even more remarkable is that farm workers are considered essential employees by both the state and federal government, yet are not even considered as employees under Maine's labor laws. And so Harnett, you know, really put some action behind his concerns and he introduced this bill. And guess what? It passed in the state legislature. The state lawmakers, and it is a solidly blue state, decided, yeah, there should absolutely be labor protections for our farm workers. And then the bill made its way to the governor's office, where Governor Janet Mills, a Democrat, decided to veto it. A Democrat in Maine decided to veto a bill that would have extended labor rights, workers' rights to farm workers. What was her reasoning? She says this, quote, "I cannot in good conscience allow a bill to become law that would subject our farmers to a complicated new set of laws that would require them to hire lawyers just to understand." So Waz, just to add insult to injury, because let me help you guys decode that statement.
Yeah.
Look, I don't want to expand workers' rights to farm workers because I think they're too stupid to understand what labor rights are. Like, that's essentially what her rationale is. I mean, what was that? What was that?
Yeah, and then, you know, she ends the statement by essentially saying it's bad for business. That's you know, like, for all of the hammer, she's just like, it's bad for business. But yeah, it's insulting that these people, you know, they wouldn't understand the consequences of a law that gave them rights. Like, it's absurd. And you know, people at home need to understand that these are some of the most exploited people in the entire labor force, right? And again, this isn't some farmhand working on your pappy's ranch. These companies are huge, multi-billion-dollar corporations. So yes, they need protections from those companies, because one individual worker cannot bump up against the demands and the will of these big old pharma companies, right? And so, yeah, it's a shame what this Democratic governor would say, when again, the people who need the protecting are these workers, period. And you know, oftentimes they could be like, oh, this is gonna hurt small business, and you know, the mom and pop, they can't afford some of these you know, these new laws and all of this and these regulations. Like, no, these are the some of the richest companies in that entire industry. They can afford to do the right thing by these workers, period.
What you guys will notice increasingly, and I think many of you have already noticed, is that as corporate interests and business, you know, lobbying groups continue to capture both political parties equally, when it comes to bread and butter issues, when it comes to substantive policy decisions, there's virtually no difference between both parties. And what we're experiencing in the country right now is this reliance on manufactured culture wars, so the two parties can, you know, at least optically set themselves apart from one another, because they still need something to campaign on. And what are you gonna campaign on when your voting record or your veto record makes it abundantly clear that you might be a Democrat? There might have been a time in this country's history where Democrats, you know, looked out for workers or the little guy, but that's not the case anymore. So now rely on the culture wars. And I think Democrats and Republicans rely on two different types of culture wars, right? The Democrats will always try to pay lip service to various disenfranchised groups in this country. But we just saw what happened with the voting rights bill. We just saw all of those activists and all of those organizers who did all that hard work on the ground in Georgia to get Biden elected, get the middle finger from the Democratic Party in regard to voting rights. The one thing that they were rallying for, the one thing they were organizing for, the one thing they were promised by Biden when he was a candidate. But what could Biden do? I mean, what else are they gonna run on? Are they gonna run on their sparkling record of looking out for the little guy, economically speaking? No. That's why the country, by the way, is also being ripped apart. Because if you just lean into culture war garbage, well, then all you do is fight with the other side based on these manufactured scare tactics. That's why you have all these Republican voters across the country like losing their minds over the perceived threat of critical race theory in elementary schools. You know, it's just, this is why we're so divided. Like, I guarantee you, if you sit people down and you ask them questions about actual like substantive policy issues, I would venture to say that there's a lot of agreement on both sides. I know it's you're not supposed to say that, but it's true. And when Democrats lose, they need to understand why. You can't veto bills like this and assume that you're gonna continue being a popular politician. And by the way, her approval rating, the governor of Maine, not doing so great. I wonder why. What are you doing for your constituents? What are you doing for the workers in Maine? Are you improving their lives, or are you looking out for the business interests?
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.